start.
Cameron, let him know when he's balanced, all right? Okay, lean back a little bit.
nasty stuff to do with it.
Thank you.
obnoxious things to Steven over here. Steven's going to be very insulted, as anyone would, in their right mind, likely be. And Anna's going to have to justify the horrible things that she's saying to make it sound like she's not a totally horrible person. So, without further ado, what exactly are Anna and Steven doing?
Come on, guys.
Anything. No, give it back.
Doing an improv show. No.
Thank you.
PR.
That's
and
always thought, the way you made those was stay on target.
Hot candy.
Maybe.
these folks can be the movie poster for. And at the end of his looking at three different movie posters, he's going to let you help him decide which one he wants to do a short scene from. So, with that in mind, Stephen, let's go to the movies.
All right. Thanks for coming with me. I just want to know, I want to see a movie about their teens and their problems.
Werewolf!
Like, do you have like a sprinkler? I love it.
I'll get that, because I don't have a liquor license.
No, you don't need a liquor license for selling it, right? Also, I brought the beer.
Thank you.
majestic.
Thank you.
how pathetic I am.
Oh my god, I'm so sorry.
I'm just trying to...
You're awkward, but not a criminal.
No, I'm not a criminal.
this food from where I am located, but I'm actually from Italy, so maybe some pizza. But I am currently in France doing croissants. Really, really fatty foods. It's making me fat.
Alright, croissants. That's number four. Alright, let's go on. That's number two. Same question.
I am on a very strict diet to maintain my figure for my, you know, my lifestyle. And you are pretty much on your own.
We got it. All right, that's number three.
I don't really know. My therapist kind of thinks I'm confused and I should stop eating insects, but I guess I know something from a coffee shop.
Sounds good. Question number two. Contestants, as you may have gathered, I enjoy food. But I also enjoy books. I tend to read on those long, worldly flights. Now, my question to you is, what book would you force me to read and why?
Just
number one.
Well, if you haven't already, I'd force you to read Da Vinci Code, so, because I'm pretty integral to the plot. I mean, without me, there is no Code or Da Vinci. And he just would have been a beggar without me.
Mr. Obvious over here. Alright, contestant number two! You like reading?
I don't read, I let the music take over, and I get the story from that. The movement and the music, it is better than a book.
That's lovely! Right, contestant number three.
Most people may argue I would read anything from a Marvel universe, but my therapist also thinks that's a really bad idea, particularly anything in red and blue. So, Sunday comics.
And we got ourselves a nerd over here. Alright, contestant number three. Me, you're not a contestant. I just refuse that. I'm just drunk. Alright. Now, contestant number two mentioned music, and that actually leads me into my third question. If you could write me a song, what would its title be, and what instrument would you play it on?
Its title would be, My Smile is Fake, but Not for You. And it would be played by, especially hitting against the wall. It's very kind and dark.
Nice. Alright, contestant number two, you remember the question?
Sure.
I don't remember. Oh, God. My song would be Perfection, because I am all about perfection. Oh, God, I don't remember how this got here. Oh, holy shit! Oh, my God, my finger's coming off! Oh, no.
Easy, the sensors! I'm gonna go.
Perfect!
Alright, you can play. Alright, that's the thing.
If I wrote a song, for someone that I call it My Spidey Senses Tingling Through. Well, my favorite songs.
Oh! That's crazy! Alright, we got time for another question.
I
on him.
No, I was trying to shake her head. Her
name.
Okay,
that
is what my lawyer is telling you with it.
All right. And, you know, I bought one of them garden gnomes yesterday.
You did?
You know why? Yes. You know why? It's awesome. Awesome. We're going to talk about that. I love awesome.
You think they're calling him?
Probably. Calling one of you on the air.
Hello?
Hello.
Hey.
Caller number one. sexy garden gnome. It's harder than you think.
That's what she said, right?
That is what she said. Thank you, Proverbs. That's all the time we have for today. Please call back next time. We'll be talking about other stuff we have.
You have a strong ring.
Yeah.
Cool. Talk about that.
Will we? Another explore why three people intentionally brought a heat lamp. mentioned that you wanted to melt the crayons.
Yes.
The smell. Yes.
I forgot to mention that I worship Picasso. Smelling his melted crayons brings me closer to the Picasso god.
I don't want to live in a world that's been created by Picasso.
Give shop,
by the way.
Give shop!